We're learning more tonight about how two brothers could have fallen in and nobody was there to help them. News 5's John London joins us live with a 911 call for help. John?
Yeah, Jack, neighbors tell us that the property owner was scrambling around to try to find someone to be able to jump in the pool and rescue the boys. At city pools like this one, where they're on a break right now, you have certified lifeguards on duty. In the backyard pool, you're sort of on your own. And tonight, police tell us no criminal aspect to pursue. And as the two young boys struggle to survive, there are steps each of us can take to lessen the dangers around water.
Neighbors in Bond Hill, where it happened, tell us today they are distraught and praying for the two boys.
Come on, we have to get those kids. Come on, you have to send someone. Nobody can swim and they can't get out of the water.
That 911 call came from the owner of the backyard pool on Cheyenne Drive. Two brothers, ages 8 and 10, were pulled from the deep end by two neighbors who were nearby. The tragic occurrence highlights how quickly someone in a pool can be in danger.
That happened at our pool the other day, that some girl, she didn't know that she could swim in the deep end. They don't know how deep it is, and then she just jumps in.
They emphasize such situations at Red Cross water safety instructor sessions like this one in Mount Auburn. The Baywatch-type rescues people might consider the norm.
That's not always the case that they're yelling. You may not always get to hear the yelling. You may just see them and just have to react.
Are not necessarily the reality of what these young lifeguards encounter. Like last night's Bond Hill tragedy, distress can happen quickly and quietly.
What's wrong there, ma'am?
A kid jumped in the pool that can't swim.
Okay, is he still in the pool?
Yes.
Seconds are vitally important. It appears no one supervising the pool at the time could swim.
Well, at my pool, there's been incidents where the young child has jumped in the water and they didn't realize they couldn't swim and they start drowning. Then the parent, at an instant, goes in the water and jumps after them. They can't swim either. And so if there's not a lifeguard around, it turns into a really bad situation.
Which points up the importance of knowing how to swim in the first place. And if you don't, make sure there's someone around who does.
It's vigilance of parents watching their kids if they're at the pools, knowing where they are, because it doesn't take much.
And as you look live here at city pool water, I spoke this afternoon with a man who jumped in that backyard pool to pull the younger boy out. He says people on Cheyenne Drive, Tawanda, and Paddock Road in Bond Hill are stunned and saddened by what happened. The latest conditions police have on the two boys are critical. Reporting live, John London, News 5.